can't believe this is going on. This is amazing. And it's honestly, it's thanks to everybody in the audience. It's thanks to the filmmakers of amazing movies like Static, like Ken Rush. And this whole goddamn festival is going to blow your mind. I hope you see some movies already. I hope you're going to go see some more. I'm not even going to talk long right now because I want to see these movies again. You guys are in for a treat. Both of these movies are just crazy. First one is weird. It's atmospheric. It's heartwarming. And the next one is just like, you're not watching the movie, you're part of the movie. We are talking about trailblazing filmmakers here, and you're here to witness it. First, Canada's first POV feature-length movie. You're here to see the world premiere. Guys, everybody should have gotten a ballot to vote on the feature for People's Pick for Best Flick. If you did not get a ballot, no worries, you can get one on the way out. Just tear through the numbers to assign. I'll go over it later, but I want everybody to enjoy yourself. I'm Bernie Newland, the festival director. Have a good treat, guys. Thank you.
Awesomeness, heartwarmingness from Tanya and crew.
And then we go on that ride. I mean, this is what the festival is all about. It's about celebrating this insane talent that we have. Actually, in this case, in the city, which is so good. Come on up, guys. Nobody fall. Here, you know what? I'm going to... Tanya? I'm going to pass this one over. Oh my God, look at all these people. Okay, nobody's ever fallen off the stage, but if there's one day it might happen, it may be today. Tanya, you want to just hold on to that for a second?
Yes.
So I'd like to ask you some questions. Let's give it up for all the filmmakers, all the cast and crew, Ben Rush and Static. That was an amazing, amazing screening, guys. That was insane. That was so good. I want to thank everybody for all your hard work that made it possible for us, for the Canadian Film Fest, to put on a screening like that. That was amazing. It was so much fun. Tanya, welcome.
Thank you.
I'm gonna ask you, if you could, to introduce your crew and everybody that's on stage.
There's a few of them over there.
What's that?
Is there anyone still left out there? They're all of you. That's Laura.
Hi, Laura.
For post-production, she did our fly cut, the most beautiful fly cut ever. Sonia is my producer, who's been with me from the very beginning of this whole thing, which was, I think, 4 years ago that I started
really?
This film. Sonia's been with me the whole time, every day, 3 in the morning. Sonia, what do I do now? And Sean's here. Sean, practical special effects.
Woo! And this is applause for everybody for dressing
through. Jyoti is one of our angel investors on the Indiegogo campaign. Wonderful. Is there anyone else here from? That's it.
Yeah, awesome. I'm going to start out because it's my festival. I get to do what I want. I love to have the first couple of questions. But if you guys do want to ask any questions throughout any time, please just put up your hands, and we'll definitely pull you out of here. But Tanya, that was awesome. It was fun. It was heartwarming. It was endearing. It was the perfect metaphor. It was all that. And how do you make sure that it stays on the right side of schmaltz? Do you know what I mean? Because you could actually very easily go over there, but you didn't. And that's why it's so effective.
That's a good question.
Well, thank you.
Well, it is tough because it is a poignant story, and it's a strong story about a man who has lost many things and is on his way to losing more. His sanity, I guess. The story, I adapted the story from a short story that was written by a UK author, a friend of mine, Rob Shearman. You guys, Doctor Who fans, you guys know Doctor Who?
Oh, I'm cool.
Rob for Doctor Who. The Dalek episode, the Dalek episode, first Daleks back in the new series. Anyway, so the story was already in place, really. The beautiful parts of the story, which was what attracted me to it, because it had those three things that I love all together in a story, which were that heartwarming poignancy, and funny, and kind of twisted, which is what always, the three things that I like to mix into the work that I do, and there was already perfectly arranged in this beautiful story about this man, love story, about this man and his team.
And a lot of that credit goes to your lead, who couldn't make it tonight.
Eric Peterson, who's at home in bed with the flu. He was going to come tonight, but he couldn't make it. So apologies from Eric, he would have loved to have been here.
But that truly was a great performance. And I wonder, some actors you have to pull back. Some actors you have to just get some more out of them. And how was it working with him?
Eric, he asked me a number of times if he should just go for it, especially in the scene, the confrontation scene between him and Billy, his son, played by Jan Cusson. who would have loved to have been here as well, but he's in LA. That particular moment, I said, just go. And I still, that bit where he's yelling at Billy still gets me every time, because it is very strong. But he felt that everything was earnest. The character felt that he was losing everything at that moment. And I thought it was important that he was cornered and had to protect himself in that moment. And I think, do you think it came through? I think it came through.
Absolutely. Actually, let's give a big does anybody have any questions for anybody in Static at the moment? There's one right here.
Killing off a pregnant lovely protagonist about half an hour into the movie.
No, we're talking about the short.
Oh, we're talking about the short.
Short first, yes.
I killed
But hold on, because I feel like that's going to be a very interesting question. Adopted died. Any questions for Static, just in case? Okay, I'm kind of blind up here. If I miss anybody, shout out. But that's the testament to the story you told, is that you were able to, and I mean, I didn't even know that it was adapted from a short story from a writer from probably my favorite TV show ever. But you did it, and you did it really well. Thank you for screening that with us. It was an absolute honor. So cheers.
Thanks for having me.
Without the Static, your time at Australia. It was a beautiful story. Alright. So now I'm gonna shift over to our feature, Dead Rush. Can I tell you, this was literally the last submission that I got, and it was so fucking late that I was pissed off at Carl for even asking me. I'm like, who the hell do you think? And I watched the rough, no, the sound wasn't done, the color wasn't done, right? I was like, holy shit, this would look amazing on the big screen if they don't screw it up from this point on, right? And it did. It was like, it was so good, guys. It was a pleasure to show this, and it's another first for us, for them, for Canada, as it's the first POV shot feature film that we've made as a country.
You guys did that.
It's awesome. We're not just making movies, we're showing the world how to make them. You guys are literally doing that. It's really cool. Anyways, enough of my gushing. Can you please introduce your crew and everybody on stage?
Okay, so I'll hi guys, there's so many train of people coming in. I'll let everyone introduce themselves, but my name is Zach, I'm the director, writer, editor of the film. We'll start here and we go this way.
Okay. I'm Eric Ripke, I'm the co-producer of the film.
I'm Charlie Hamilton, and I'm Wayne, I play Wayne.
I'm Carl Jace, I'm cinematographer and producer.
I'm Raven Cousins. I acted and wrote and co-produced.
My name is Nick Davey, and I did the ADR recording, the voiceover recording, some music, and zombie sounds.
Hi, I'm Justin Moses. I was the stunt coordinator and tactical zombie who was doing a lot of running around, I think, throughout the film. But yeah, it was our baby for some crazy stunt choreo. So.
Rich Biotowski, I play Patrick.
Hi, I'm Kaylee LeGrand, and I play Carly.
I'm David Michael Moot, and I play David, and I was POV camera operator as well.
Hi, I'm John Holman, and I was a production assistant.
Yeah! Hi, I'm Trevor Romine Jr. I did Stills, BTS, I did some zombie noises, and I played Marcus.
Hello, I'm Ron Sarabia, and I was a grip.
Nice!
Liz May, and I was the assistant director. I'm Rachel Lauderman, I'm your production designer, and I've been asked by our generous friends to introduce them. This is my wonderful art director, our wonderful talent, Austin Duffy. This is Zachary Peltier. Oh my gosh, that was embarrassing. We're like really old friends. The wonderful special effects makeup artist, Tabitha. We've got our sound guys, Alex and Chad. Chad. Our grip and fuse is coming out as well. Thanks very much for coming out, guys.
Okay, guys, you have been non-stop in promoting your movie. Yeah. You've been non-stop in getting it done in time for the festival. You filmed a little extra credit sequence just for this room. You guys did that for you guys. Right? The world premiere did, right? So now that that's all over, like, where do you go from here with your move?
Bed.
Carl, you can start. I don't know what to say.
Well, right now we actually are in sales. Obviously, Ruthless Pictures are executive producers, so something exciting to announce, we've actually already sold the film, The United Kingdom.
Yeah.
If anyone wants to buy the movie, just let me know.
That's all. Oh, and again, if anybody has any questions, just put up their hands. I do have one. The technology used to some of it was existing. I'm sure you MacGyvered some stuff. How did you make it so immersive for us with the technology that you had at your disposal? And what kind of jury rigging did you have to do?
When we started doing Dead Rush, it originated as a short film, and when we did that, it was literally like a horseback riding helmet, this pink riding helmet, with like a DSLR on the front and then weights on the back, and that was it. And I thought I was the coolest thing. I'm like, look at what I made. And I show Carl, and I'm like, look at this. And Carl's like, oh yeah, that's good. And then he comes with this like Tony Stark built helmet rig, looked like it was part of a robot, and that's what we shot Dead Rush on. Carl can talk about it more.
So the film was shot on Sony A7S, Odyssey 7Q Plus recorder, for anybody that actually understands that in the room. Details. But actually, yeah, so built out of a motorcycle helmet, recorder on the back, wireless video, wireless focus, lens up front. It was really important for me to let the actor, David McGowan, and obviously David was super into the idea of actually operating the camera himself and immersing the audience in the film as the main character and as the driving force behind the film. So it's super important for me to be able to give him the ability to kind of show all of you the movie that we set up to make.
So as an actor, actually want to pass the. Yeah. So how was that being actor, camera person, DOP even sometimes, I'm sure? Like, how was that for you?
Yeah, I definitely learned a lot of being on this side of the camera for sure. Yeah, it was great, and just working with all the different actors, that was really cool too, to see, to still try to be in it and give a performance to them that they could work off of as well, and get the shot at the same time, and there was a lot to think about and a lot to do, but I think we pulled it off.
Oh, absolutely, most definitely. Guys, congratulations, it's really good. There's a lot of, I love this, that's a lot of returning faces. You guys were here last year. Kaylee, you were here as well. You're always here. You're like in everything. It's like every festival, you're in at least a movie or two.
Yeah, this is my microphone. I brought it from home.
You did it. Every time she smiles, it's like she did something wrong. And I think that translates, that translates onto the screen. There's something about you. And I'm sure we're going to see a lot more from you. Are you working on anything else right now?
Yes, I have a couple of films and web series under the belt right now.
What, you want to tell me?
You'll hear about those shortly. I don't think I have a lot to talk about them right now.
Okay. Okay, awesome. So guys, thank you for bringing your movie here. That was an experience. It's something else. It's something to watch an amazing movie, but to be the dude or the dudette or whatever. it's something new, and it's something really, really cool. And I want to thank you on behalf of the CFF and MLS, and thank everybody here, everybody from Static, from Dead Rush. That was an amazing screening. Thank you so much, everybody. Let's give these guys a round of applause.